Assalamualaikum, my name is Widi Mutakin from Expose Academy. I get this question a lot from my students. How can I create a hole on the polygon surface? Well, the answer to this question really depends on the context. What type of hole? On what kind of surface? In this video tutorial, I'm going to show you guys different ways of creating holes on polygon surface. I'll be covering 4 different methods in this video. First, creating circular hole on a flat surface. Second method is adding circular hole on a non-flat surface or curved surface. Next, we'll discuss creating custom shape hole on a flat surface. And last, we're going to cover how we can create custom shape hole on non-flat surface. Before we continue, I'd like to mention that this video tutorial is intended for intermediate level user. So I will assume that you're already familiar with basic modeling techniques in 3ds Max. If we look in this 3D scene that I have, let's say I want to create a circular hole right in this vertex position. As usual, a quad-based surface will create vertices that have 4 edge branches like this. Well, for our circle, 4 edges aren't enough. We need to have at least 8 edge branches from this vertex. So, we're going to use paint connect to add more edges. If you don't know what paint connect is, please check my other tutorial about paint connect versus cut tool. Okay, go to ribbon interface, modeling, edit, and paint connect. After it is active, indicated by this mouse cursor, hold control and click drag from this vertex to the center vertex and to this vertex. Do this also with this side. Another way to create something like this is by using the connect command. To show you how to do that, I'm going to undo several times. Okay, pick all of these 5 vertices, then click the connect button. As you can see, we have the same result. It is up to you whether you want to use the first method or the second one. Okay, now that we have something like this, we can select the vertex at the center and chamfer it. This will result a new circular polygon like this one. Of course, the circle is not high count polygon, so it's suitable for adding norms later on. For example, we select the polygon and extrude it several times and add inset at the end. Now, when we apply norms to it, we have something like this. Next method is to create circular hole also, but this time the surface is not flat. Instead, it's curved. The main concept is actually still the same. Prepare the base for our hole, then we create the hole. We can use tessellate if we need to subdivide it locally. But for our case, I want to create the hole from these 6 polygons in here. So select all of them and delete. Go to border mode and cap to close the hole. Go to polygon mode, select the polygon, and now go to ribbon interface again, polygon, and click this geopoly button in here. Notice the polygon edges now form a circular shape. Now this technique sometimes produces twisted angle or the position is not correct. Well, we can simply adjust the polygon manually. Go to rotation mode, make sure it is set to local and rotate it as you like. Also, you can move this in local coordinate to any place that makes sense. Sometime in old version of 3ds Max, this geopoly method produced strange polygon behavior. It's not happening to me now. But if this ever happened to you, just select the polygon and click this retriangulate button and that should fix the issue. After having the circular form, you can do whatever you want with this polygon. You can delete it or extrude it like before. Next, we're going to create a custom shaped hole on a flat surface. In this technique, we're going to basically replace a polygon with a spline-based geometry. In this example, we have a cube and we want to create a star-shaped hole in this side. First, we delete the polygon at that side. Then we need to create a spline from this border. So select the border first, then click this Create Shape from Selection button. Just choose linear. Now we have a spline in here. Next, we need to create the star shape. To do that, go to front viewport and create the star shape. Back to perspective viewport and make sure the 3D snap is on. And it's in vertex snapping mode. Slide the position in y-axis so it's aligned to the spline we have before. Convert the star to an editable spline. Choose attach. And then choose the spline. And just convert this to an editable poly object. So we have something like this. Something to take note is that you need to have the star object as the master spline that conduct the attach command, not the rectangular spline. Why? Because the Z local coordinate of the star is correct, which is facing this way, while the rectangular spline Z local coordinate is not correct, as it's facing this way based on its original cube object. Many modeling feature and modifier work based on the Z local coordinate. So if you choose the rectangular spline as the master attach, you'll get into troubles down the road. Finally, we can fix the topology with the paint connect tool to get quad polygons. Of course, this step is optional, for example, if you need to apply norms later on. The last technique we're going to discuss is creating custom shape hole on curved surface. Basically, we're going to use a special create object operation called shape merge. This shape merge operation will require us to have at least two objects. One will be the polygon or mesh object to be cut, and another one will be the spline, which will cut the hole into the mesh object. In here we have a teapot. Go to front viewport and create a star spline again just like before. Now select the teapot and go to create, compound object, shape merge. Click on the pick object button, then choose the star shape. Scroll down and turn on this cookie cutter. Okay, now we can convert the object to an editable poly object. Usually, this process will produce a lot of double edge vertices like these and also non-quad polygons. To fix this, we can use the paint connect tool to handle the edges so we have quad-based polygons. Also, we can remove unwanted vertices by selecting the vertices and right-click then remove. Or you can also use backspace key to do this. Don't use the delete key because it will also delete the polygons attached to that vertex. Okay, we cover so much in this video. I hope this tutorial is beneficial to you guys. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I am planning to create a new online course in the near future that will be free only to my YouTube subscribers, inshallah. So again, to get the free access, just subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Wassalamualaikum.